This is a story of heartbreak, a story of one man going against the system, a man going against controversy.
After a failed attempt
of creating exciting content for KSBY, Rishi set on a quest people actually cared about. That was the Spider-Man interview. After Spider-Man not making show due to reasons unknown to the producers, it never aired. Now, Rishi must create something spectacular, impeccable, compelling, immaculate. This is the story of the comeback.
My name is Rishi, and I'm going around CHS to interview staff and students about their thoughts and feelings about heartbreak. What's your definition of heartbreak?
What?
Can we restart the... Sorry, right, I was
right.
Wait.
This is
horrible. Nope.
Anything that has to do with another guy.
You're just like sitting there and you feel like empty.
Somebody that is not able to fulfill your expectation.
Having an emotional connection with someone and then that kind of fading away.
Somebody does something to you and it makes you really sad.
When I see you.
Ooh, shit.
When you love someone, they'll feel the same about you.
Never want to talk to anyone again or date anyone again ever.
The loss of someone you love.
You really put all your time and effort into someone. Someone breaks up with you and they just make it invalid.
Puts them in a very bad place.
Lose something you love.
Emotional can take like a long time to recover from.
If she talking, if she breathing, if she like anything that has to do with another guy.
Letting go of you.
All the time and effort was worth nothing.
It's a bad thing. I wouldn't wish it on anyone, I guess.
Losing someone that meant so much to you.
The complicated thing.
She hard to move on.
Getting broken up with? Pain.
I got one.
Leave all that shit behind, you know what I'm saying?
It makes you do unbelievable things. You won't eat, you can't sleep. It's a lot of things that go into it.
She makes you cry sometimes.
Not being able to wake up in the morning.
Someone probably like breaking up with you or something bad happening to you.
Getting your soul crushed.
When your heart splits in half because the person you love hurts you and breaks up with you.
Really hurt in the inside.
When your perception of someone totally shatters and you don't know who they are anymore.
It makes you do things that you've never done before. Like, you get really angry, start getting mad at your friends. Like, and that could all be over a girl. So guys, like, don't lose your best friends over girls.
Being heartbroken by someone if they treat you wrong
physically makes you sick and disgusted and you just wanna not be with them anymore.
Getting played.
Do something crazy for a girl and like she break your heart, bro, just like let it go, bro. I promise you it's not worth it.
When someone ghosts me.
Causes you pain.
If someone like breaks up with you and you're sad because of it.
Losing someone that you really care about.
You miss that person and that person's gone and you can't do anything about it.
When you have gotten your heart intertwined with another person.
I actually wanted to ask you.
No.
Dude,
why can't
not,
you
no,
answer it?
No, we're not. I know what you're gonna say.
The hopes and expectations that you had aren't met.
Have you been heartbroken before, FaZe?
No.
Alright, thank you. You got any real-life story you can tell us?
They fail their tests, they don't turn in work, they skip school.
Grandpa passed away around Christmas time. It was really sad, that first Christmas without him.
My ex got with my ex-best friend. And I found out about it, but I was dating his best friend, so I couldn't say anything.
His name was Patrick, and that's all I'm willing to say.
I didn't have a reaction because I kind of did the same thing, but like it was still hurt, you know.
Have you ever broken a guy's heart before?
I think so, but this is so bad.
I think I know the guy too.
I dated this one girl, no names or anything, but she got with my best friend at the time. Yeah, not my best friend, but like I was close with him, and she got with him after we broke up. But I think she got with him because he looks like me, and he's like the off-brand version. But it's fine though. Yeah,
we're chilling. Does his name start with an E?
Maybe.
This girl broke up with me because I took her to McDonald's.
Bengals losing the Super Bowl.
We didn't have a job or money at the time, so I only had 20 bucks, but now she's like jealous because I have a job now.
Say a year and a half ago, I was talking to this girl, and you know, I was really into her, and I was spitting mad game and stuff. And she actually went and found another guy within a week. And it was pretty heartbreaking because I thought, like, you know, we could be something.
I just lost feelings, and it broke my heart to end things with her.
One time, this girl and I were dating, right? And, you know, we were dating for a while. You know, we were in love, you know? And my friend, he actually is sitting beside me. He's wearing a Washington State hoodie. He took her from me. And I've never really forgave him about that.
It broke my heart to break her heart.
About 2 months later, I started talking to this new girl. Now I'm dating her, so it was great.
It was my birthday, and I had really counted on Nandini being there. We had planned it for a long time, and she just decided not.
Wait, I couldn't show up because... Because my parents didn't let me go out because... Please, sorry. You were mad about that? I'm so sorry.
I tore my ACL and the doctor said I couldn't play football.
She was absolutely out of her mind and she's missing out on this. Worst decision of her life, but I'm a king. Move on from that kind of stuff.
She cried and like I couldn't move.
Yeah, I was on FaceTime with this girl, right? And then like day after, you know, she blocked me. I was heartbroken.
Oh. I don't know who she thought she was.
I felt helpless. I got blocked.
One time my fifth grade boyfriend didn't give me a Valentine and gave my friend one. And then we broke up after that.
Got dumped by a girlfriend in high school, middle school, college. Well, early on in college before my wife now.
In sixth grade, I had a boyfriend and he didn't tell me that we broke up, but he like texted it on a group chat with all our friends. And I was really sad.
Broke up with my girlfriend. She was toxic.
This is a friend of mine. He likes you. Do you like him?
I know what you're referring to, and I am going to have to decline. Thank you, though.
You know you watch this show, right?
I'm really sorry. I'm still heartbroken over Patrick.
All right, Neil, if you're watching this right now, she's single right now. Well, folks, you see, heartbreak, it's more than an emotional thing. It's more than a relationship thing. No. It happens to all of us. It happens to some of us. But something, it happens to CHS staff and students. I'm Rishi, and I'm signing out.
Joe Burrow should have won that. He showed up with a great pregame fit. He had the hat on. He had the suit on. I thought he was going to take us. Ref sold. Rams are paying the ref.
I'm Amy. Welcome to my crib.
I think the Russians actually invented love and dispersed it amongst the Americans.
Yo,
so
what?
Interview me, bro.
What
you
can
follow my theme page, JDM_Legends21. And I guess my TikTok too, but I don't even use that anymore.
So this is the senior bridge. This is a ugly fat fella.
Okay, buddy.
If anyone asks you, just be like, it's like natural, okay? Like,
between me and Neil.
I just wanted to say hi to Rishi because I really love this kid. I've known him for a long time.
Say a fun little fact about you.
I'm not friends with her.
It's not true. I'm his best friend.
I'm friends with a really handsome looking fella. Oh, name's Neil.
Oh,
I'll tell you all about
him. He actually is in love with Jack Fishpaw, the quarterback. He's his number one cheerleader.
I think one of the greatest memories me and Rishi ever had was definitely a seventh grade athletics banquet. It's honestly a core memory and a memory we still talk about
that,
to this day.
I remember that.
Seventh grade athletics banquet is probably a core memory that which will always define mine and his friendship. I love you, Rishi.
Well, I love you all. Say you. Appreciate it. Thank you.
Amy Hartquist. And I, too, am in case of EY. This is my best bud.
Joe Bro should have won that.
I'm sorry, you're tickling me. Are you still recording?
Hey, what do you think about Blackfish?
Don't tickle me, Oh, wait, don't tickle me. Come on, dude. Don't stop tickling, dude.
I'm not tickling you. Damn it, just start talking, Casey. Start talking.
Rishi, you're tickling
start talking.
Me.
Let's put some game.
Fifteen-year-old sneaky links, man, it's crazy.
I'm sorry to hear about that, Rishi.
You look pretty good for 40.
I know.
You ever been heartbroken?
Not really, because I've never been attached.
I love you too. I love all of you too. You ever been heartbroken? You ever been heartbroken?
No.
How do you know what heartbreak is then?
Well, like, I know how it's been for other people. So, but I've never been heartbroken.
Tell me a story.
I can't. It's confidence.
All right, that's fine.
I took Facebook 3 months ago to bring an audience. That's so much. Am I being recorded?
Yeah. Oh, this is gonna go on the. Okay.
Hello.
Oh, my dad took my Xbox once away. That made me pretty sad.
Is it filming? This is KCBY with Amy and
Rishi.
We are best friends.
All right, this segment's over. Thank you very much.
What the fuck is this class, man? Oh my god.